Dr. Dwight made a friend.
Dwight, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
This is gold. This is going on Facebook.
I'm going to get in trouble. I'll probably get arrested and thrown in jail.
Good morning. It may not be your morning, but it is definitely our morning here. So we are on our way to South Africa. This is our first major road trip since arriving here in Mozambique. We have to fix Winky Wonky, our truck, who these days is more wonky than Winky. So we are taking it to South Africa to get it looked at because we have tried here and been relatively unsuccessful. Dwight and Lynn are going to orientate us to South Africa, where we go for medical care, where we go to the dentist, where we go for pharmacy, where we go for pretty much anything healthcare related. It's where we go to do a lot of business, buy equipment, that sort of thing. So that is our adventure. We are on our way. What you looking at?
I think this is supposed to be like this.
And what's that from?
I think this is when Dwight hit a hole.
Is it what's it from though? What vehicle?
This is from our truck.
And is that what started our problems?
One of the problems, but I'm gonna show it's pretty funny. I think Dwight did that.
After Josh has been busy blaming busy blaming Pastor Dwight for all this damage on the car, I just thought it was fair that Pastor Dwight also got to make his case.
I was driving at a simple 60 kilometers an hour down a dirt road.
In Mozambique.
In the dark, on the Zambezi River, and all of a sudden, the road absolutely just disappeared. I thought we were all dead because we hit so hard. Everything fell out of the back of the vehicle. Poor Shannon fell on the floor in the back seat. That was probably
we stopped and we went back on the road looking for pieces of car, but there weren't any laying on the road.
That's because they were all bent up inside.
I like to wear high shorts now and say yaw, because it's very South African. Guys wear really high shorts here, so much so that it looks like they're getting wedgies.
Is that what you've learned about South Africa?
Yeah, I hiked up my shorts today and I started saying yaw. I gave myself a bit of a wedgie. My pants were really tight around my big butt.
Where are we going?
We're going to Kruger Park with Dwight and Lynn.
What's Kruger Park?
It's a safari park. Yes, last night we watched the digital version of a safari in 3D.
In South Africa.
In South Africa, and now we're actually going to a real park. I want to eat you.
So here we are, finally home from South Africa. It was a long trip home.
24 hours.
And I think it was just a really good time for both of us just to reflect about what we've seen and experienced since coming to Mozambique and to process a lot of emotions. Mm-hmm. And it was just really amazing today when we got here, came back to the mission, how much it felt like coming home.
We like Mokumbezi a lot.
We love Mokumbezi. Even though we just landed, we know that there is going to be a boatload of work ahead of us. Mm-hmm. And we're ready. We're ready to take it on and just see what God has for us.
The Bible actually says that we are enemies of God.
A Bíblia diz que nós somos inimigos de Deus.
But when we accept Jesus and He lives inside of us,
mas quando aceitamos Jesus e Ele viver dentro de nós,
tingamos Jesus a ficar na fé. God brings us into His family.
Joao, how are you doing, Joao? So
high.
Hey!
are taking a huge tree out, and I'm very scared it's gonna fall on the house. We have a rope, we have a tractor, we have a whole bunch of guys watching.
Hey guys, so we're back from a town called Guru. We just did a festival with 680 kids.
Between the ages of 5 and 12.
It was amazing.
But it was chaos.
We got invited to go share at their youth rally. Chelsea and I, the nursing team, we brought Jeanette, and Dwight was there as well. And we just loved on the kids. We shared some Bible stories.
But it was really incredible just to be there and show up, just to recognize that even though we weren't 100% organized all the time, 100% prepared, really what was important for them, that we were there and that we were just sharing the love of Jesus with them. And I think for me that was really an encouragement, because I think sometimes since arriving here it feels like we just need to have everything so perfectly organized. But I think today was just such an encouragement for both of us to just try and to just start and to trust that God will use what we can offer, even if it's broken pieces or a little bit complicated, and to trust that in the midst of it, as long as we are loving God and loving others, then there'll be good fruit. So even though we're super tired, we're super content and super thankful that we got the chance to share in it.
So we'll talk soon, guys. Have a good night.